This is
I don't know if it's just like riding a bike, but you're always prepared. And I think with this offense, obviously all our weapons that we have and staying prepared each and every moment, I think you just stay ready. And when your number's called, you just go in there and do what you did in practice in the meeting rooms, and you just take it to the game.
What do you think if you get started at the 2-yard line? They don't even cut you a break. What are your thoughts at that point?
Yeah, I mean, they did a great job. I mean, changing field position just like we did. And I think at that point, it's just take what they give you. You know, just a couple of the first play was a stick, hit Kelsey and kind of got us going. Then we had a nice run. And, you know, you get in a little rhythm and you kind of keep the pressure on. And, you know, the biggest thing was just rely on your preparation just like you do in practice.
Does that mean that you weren't exactly nervous and that you're kind of thrust into a situation? How do you make that part of it work?
Well, I mean, definitely nerves are high. You know, 2 years ago when I did it, the same thing. But once you get on in the end of the game and you kind of get going, it's just like repetition. And it's not like I've never done it before. I played in enough games, but when the opportunity is called upon, I feel like I'm ready.
Did you specifically draw on that game against Cleveland? I mean, was that kind of in your mind?
A little bit, but obviously it's just one play at a time. I mean, concentrate the most, the best you can, and, you know, just do what you do.
Did you ask for the third short? Is that one of your specialties in the
league? Yeah, just a quick rollout, right, and hit the flat. No, it was one of the plays that was in our 3rd and 2-to-4 group, and it was ranked high for me. But that's what's great about this organization and Coach Reed and EB and Nagy. It's just when your plays are ranked, they believe in that. They believe what you believe in, and you feel very comfortable when the play does come in and to execute it.
Yeah, Patrick talked about that you don't get the reps during the practice and during the week because it's playoffs. How important are those mental reps for you?
Yeah, I mean, mental reps are big. I mean, Shane and I and Chris are always in the back. When Patrick is up there on offense, we're in the back doing the drops, doing our run reads as well. So we're always in the back doing mental reps. But at the same time, after practice, we get with a couple of receivers and we throw with them. Not that they're the starters, but we kind of get those reps that Patrick got in practice that we'll get in after practice.
How much did you feel you settled in after that initial throw to Travis to start the
track? Yeah, I mean, it was a good completion to get going. I don't think you ever really just like settle in just on one play, but you feel the rhythm. You kind of get that first down, and you just go with the flow. And I think all the plays that were coming in, I felt confident in, and that's due to our coaching staff as well. You know, just believing in what I believe in as well, and we're all on the same page.
One of the guys said that when you're getting ready, telling some jokes when you came into the game. How did you cut the tension? How did you kind of, you know, break the nervousness that everybody had?
Yeah, I don't think it was jokes. I think it's just being confident. I think looking the guys in the eye, exemplifying some of the words in the offense that we do, and just really just get their attention, and knowing that you believe in them as well as them believing in me. So I think just giving them confidence that I know what I'm doing, and it's just not a one man show. I mean, there's a lot of great guys on our offense that really stepped up and helped my job a lot tonight. Yeah, I think he was just telling me what I tell him, take what they give you. And I think rely back on your fundamentals. And we tell each other that all the time. And he was great being there, encouraging, and just on the sideline, just like I would be. So I always appreciate him. He's just the ultimate competitor and teammate. And I couldn't thank him enough.
Jeff, what was your awareness of like what was going on with him that he went back to the extra and just kind of focused on everything else that was happening for you?
Yeah, I mean, it was going back and forth, obviously, whether he's going to play or not. And obviously, Patrick wanted to play, and Coach Reed just wanted to just get it checked out just to make sure it wasn't, you know, anything really severe. But the competitor that Patrick is, he keeps fighting. So I just knew at that point in time, I just need to be ready. I need to warm up. And if they're going with me, I'm ready. And if not, Patrick's in.
Last two. Hey, Chad, even as a veteran, I mean, thinking back to the divisional game and then this time, for Andy to have the confidence to call a pass play on the first snap when you come in, does that help you? Does that instill confidence in you?
Yeah, absolutely. And I think that's why he's such a great coach. I mean, any quarterback that comes in the system seems to have success. And he believes in the guys that are on his team. And, you know, he had the confidence in me to throw the pass, obviously. But at the same time, we're not changing the offense. We're going to go out there and try to execute to the best of our ability and move the ball. So that's our jobs as players.
Last one. Coach Reed said that the whole team just believed in you as soon as you went out there. Just talk about the grit and the heart of this team to be in that position when you were in.
Yeah, I mean, ever since I got here in 2018, this is one of the best organizations I've ever been a part of. I mean, it's a true team feeling. Everybody supports one another. There's never a guy out there that's just above anybody else. We put our egos at the side. Everybody's humble. Everybody gives the credit when it's due. And that's what makes it such great. And it comes from the top down, you know, with Clark, you know, to everybody, to Coach Reed. It's just unbelievable organization that we run here. And I couldn't be happier that I'm here.
Great. Thank you.
Thanks, guys.